In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Oh, good morning, everyone, and welcome to our parishioners from St. Edward's Golders Green and others who may also be watching this recording of Mass on Sunday, the 23rd of August. It's the 21st Sunday in ordinary time. Today's Gospel is a turning point in the life of Peter when he professes his faith in Jesus as the promised Messiah. That commitment to Christ in faith proved difficult to live out. Peter needed forgiveness several times. So do we. Lord Jesus, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, in you we find freedom from sin and fullness of redemption. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you call us to live in the truth. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. O God, who calls the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. Thus says the Lord of hosts to Shebna, the master of the palace, I dismiss you from your office, I remove you from your post, and the same day I call on my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I invest him with your robe, gird him with your sash, entrust him with your authority, and he shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I place the key of the house of David on his shoulder. Should he open, no one shall close. Should he close, no one shall open. I drive him like a peg into a firm place. He will become a throne of glory for his father's house. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Romans. How rich are the depths of God, how deep his wisdom and knowledge, and how impossible to penetrate his motives or understand his methods. Who could ever know the mind of the Lord? Who could ever be his counselor? Who could ever give him anything or lend him anything? All that exists come from him. All is by him and for him. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I will be in your heart and on your lips, that you may worthily proclaim his holy gospel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he put this question to his disciples: Who do people say the Son of Man is? And they said, Some say he is John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. But you, he said, who do you say I am? Then Simon Peter spoke up. You are the Christ, he said, the Son of the living God. Jesus replied, Simon, son of Jonah, you are a happy man, because it was not flesh and blood that revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. So I now say to you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the underworld can never hold out against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be considered bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be considered loosed in heaven. Then he gave his disciples strict orders not to tell anyone that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When I was a young boy, I used to be an altar server at St. Mary's in Ponders End. And so regularly with a few other boys, I used to turn up for the first Mass on Sunday morning and serve. There's one day I was in the sacristy with the other boys and also Father Finn, who was the parish priest at the time. And there was a little knock on the door and a man came in and he wanted to talk to the PP. And I was a bit surprised because he came in and then he went down on one knee and he genuflected to the parish priest. Now, I've seen people genuflecting to the tabernacle, but I'd never seen anybody actually genuflect to a priest. Do you think there's any chance of that happening in Golders Green? Dream on, I can hear you saying. But it's an easy way in, I suppose, to this whole question of how authority operates within the church and what should it be doing. And this is in the context, remember, over these weeks we've been going with St. Matthew over the sayings of Jesus about the community of faith, the church. How does it show forth, point to the kingdom of heaven? And we'll look at how Peter today is given that commission to be the leader of the community. Now, the whole question of authority and its exercise is really quite a hot potato around the world today in so many places. There are people going out on the streets to demonstrate against the way that authority is being used. And certainly the things that happen in society and have a kind of parallel with the church as well, that what happens in society in general, very often you can see it reflected in the church. And I guess that one of the main things that's been pointed out is the change in what was called deference. We are now much more of an informal kind of society, especially when dealing with people in authority. And to be honest, the notion of somebody genuflecting to a priest now seems kind of ludicrous. I think, from what I can see, that bishops are very uncomfortable now if people come up and kiss their rings. But within our living memory, that would have been quite a common thing to do. There's the story told about Matt Busby, the Manchester United manager, who was a very committed Catholic. The Bishop of Salford came into the dressing room before a game, and there they all were, all the paraphernalia of the players getting ready for the game. And Matt Busby did in fact go down on one knee and he kissed the ring of the bishop. Hard to see that kind of thing happening nowadays. How should, though, authority be seen in the context of the kingdom of heaven? How does it further that establishing of God's reign on earth? Can we just go back a couple of weeks? Do you remember that parable that we had about the dragnet? This is the net that brings in all the fish. And some of the fish are wonderful, great, we love them. But it also brings in the not so attractive creatures, the species that really we're probably going to throw away if it was left to us. But the net brings them all in to the shore. We have a tendency, I'm sure I'm right here in saying this, we want to divide people up. We do want to sort out the worthwhile and the useless. And we kind of judge people, I think, like that day by day. We decide very quickly whether we want someone to be with us or we'd really rather reject it. We swipe left and we swipe right. Isn't that the way that things have become now? But that doesn't fit with the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is not about making who's worthy, who's the in crowd, and who doesn't fit in. The purpose of the kingdom of heaven is to draw everyone in. So when leadership is being exercised, it's not about creating a crowd of really A-listers, people who are competent and wonderful, and consigning the rest to where they don't matter. That's not what the kingdom of heaven is about. So the leadership has to be within that context. Now, that's no excuse for poor leadership. It'd be very difficult to make a case for the Borgia popes. They were not a good advert for the church and for leadership within that context. But there is a different way of looking at leadership within the church, which doesn't always go hand in hand with the way that secular authority is seen. In the kingdom of heaven, in the church, leadership is about opening up the prospect of the kingdom for as many as possible. It's about opening the door so that people can get a glimpse of that kingdom and may be attracted to want then to go through and into that kingdom. That's the kind of leadership that should work in the church. That's the kind of help to people which makes the kingdom of God more accessible to as many as possible.
Let's proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Lord, you have promised your church the keys of the kingdom. With confidence in your care for her, we offer our prayers and petitions.
We pray for the church throughout the world, that Christian communities may be seen as places of welcome for people of every nation, race, and tradition. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the world's leaders and diplomats, that all nations may work together for justice and build a world of peace and hope for future generations. We pray especially for peace in Syria and Yemen. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask for the wisdom of the Holy Spirit for scientists and politicians, that they may find nexts to safeguard and heal us this time of the coronavirus pandemic. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask for God's blessing on all those who are receiving exam results this summer. May they be touched by God's guiding hand as they take their next step forward. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for this Sunday's Mass intentions. In thanksgiving for Lillian Kimata and for the repose of the soul of Father John Helm and for all who died recently. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all who are sick, at home or in care, and for all who are in hospital, that they may be comforted by the Lord who is with them in their trouble. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us ask Mary, the Queen of Heaven, to pray with us as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for our own families and friends.
Loving Father, the Holy Spirit has revealed your Son, Jesus, to us, and blessed the Church with his abiding presence. We rejoice in his saving work, and confident in his intercession at your right hand, we make these our prayers through the same Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts.
Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Let's pray now, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our church and for all his holy people.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just to give you thanks and raise to you a hymn of glory and praise, O Lord, Father of infinite goodness. For by the word of your Son's gospel, you have brought together one church from every people, tongue, and nation. And having filled her with life by the power of your Spirit, you never cease through her to gather the whole human race into one. Manifesting the covenant of your love, she dispenses without ceasing the blessed hope of your kingdom and shines forth bright as the sign of your faithfulness, which in Christ Jesus our Lord you promised would last for eternity. And so with all the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, while with all the church, as with one voice, we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favour on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us,
and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Lord, renew your church by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people, together with Francis our Pope, Vincent our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Edward, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, obedient to our Lord's command, let's pray as he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow to each other as a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. Amen. The blood of Christ. Amen. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Great to have you with us at Mass today. Always good to know that people are sharing with us in these moments. The Sunday Masses will continue at 10 a.m. and 12 noon. Remember, there are no toilet facilities and face coverings are now mandatory, so do please observe that ruling. We do need more stewards to help at the Sunday Masses. Please see either myself or David Lawrence if you can help. Now, we're wondering, would there be need for a Sunday evening Mass? We would need stewards as well as readers and special ministers, and I'd be glad to hear if parishioners would want to attend a Sunday evening Mass, so talk to me about that. Weekday Mass is on Monday and Thursday, open to parishioners. Church will be open from 9 a.m. and the Mass will be at 10 o'clock. Remember, there are no toilet facilities. Food bank collection continues on Sunday from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. The items requested this week are tins of fruit, tins of rice, pudding and custard, sanitary pads, no tampons, and shampoos, preferably two-in-ones. Registration for First Communion and Confirmation. Parents and young people who want to enrol in next year's sacramental programmes should email Alvaro. His email address is in the newsletter and on the website. And Saturday evening prayer. The numbers for this, it was being done on Zoom, have been small, so the last one for that will be on Saturday, the 28th of August. Do take care and enjoy the week ahead. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Quod carne carnis condit.